Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial I want to show you how you can use ActiveCampaign, their site tracking. So let's dive right in. So first I want to tell you a bit about what it is and how you can install it. So it's actually really easy. So now, what is it? So with site tracking, you can connect your email marketing basically with your website. So you install a script and then you can see what your email contacts are doing on your website. And then based on that activity, you can add tags and you can also trigger automations. So if you're using ActiveCampaign, I really think you should be using site tracking, and it's also really easy to do, and I will now show you how. So how do you install it? So the first thing you have to do, you have to go over to ActiveCampaign, and then you have to go to your settings. You can find those here. Then you go to tracking. And then you have to enable site tracking. Now you see that here that I already have enabled it. And what you then have to do, I'll set it here, you have to whitelist your domains and subdomains. So you see here that I already did that. I already added my main website and then also my membership environment. So if you have more websites, you can just add those here. Just make sure that you don't include www. Just enter your domain name and your subdomain names, and then you're all set. Now, and you also want to make sure that it includes all your web pages. Now, when you did that, you have to install the tracking code. Now, that sounds really taggy, but it's basically just copy paste. You just copy this. I do that here. And then you have to go over to your website. So it depends how your website is built, but you have to put it either in the header code of your website or in the footer code. They recommend to put it in the footer. I'm a bit naughty, I sometimes still put it in the header because then, okay, it will just load quicker, but it maybe has some impact on your website performance, so just keep that in mind. But if you want to add it to your header of your website, and if you are using WordPress, maybe you're using something else, but then in WordPress, it's really easy to do it if you go to Appearance, Theme Editor, and then you have to make sure you're using a child theme. That means that you don't break your main theme, and then you go over to header.php, and then you can just paste it in there and it will start working right away. So you can either do that or you can use a plugin. I found this really easy plugin by WBeginner. It's really easy. I've not used it myself, but I saw some videos and it looks super, super, super easy. So if this is a little bit too complicated, then you can also do that. You can really easily install headers and footers into your website. So you could either do that. And then, yeah, as soon as you edit that code, if you click update file, then it will start tracking your visitors, which is really, really cool, I think. So that's really easy to set up, right? So then I want to show you three cool possibilities. I want to show you how you can tag interests. And I want to show you how you can create like a simple abandonment cart. And then I also want to show you how you can, if you're doing like some kind of promotion, how you can automatically exit people who like purchased your offer. So let's do that. So we go over to automations, and then we're going to create a new automation. Then I'm going to start from scratch. I'm going to click continue. And then we wait till it's created. And then it will ask what start trigger we want to add to our automation. So a start trigger is what is starting this automation, what is like triggering this for that contact. So what I want to do is I want to trigger the automation when a web page is visited. So I'm going to click this and then I click continue, and then it's going to ask now for which domain is that. Now I'll do this for my main domain, maxcolumber.com, and then I want to trigger it for every web page because we're going to like tag interests. So I'm going to check what pages someone is visiting and how often they are doing that. So then you have to add a wildcard for that. I also say that here, use like a star for a wildcard. And that means that it will just trigger for everything. And then you have to say how often or like, yeah, when you want to run it. Do you want to run this automation once for that contact, or do you want to run it multiple times? Now, in this case, we want to run it multiple times. So every time they visit a page on your website, we are going to trigger this automation. Now, then you can also segment to contacts entering this automation. We do not need it for this. And then we're going to click add start. Now, then what we want to do is, now first, let's give it a name, interest tagging. That's how I would call it. And then we're going to create a bunch of different if else paths, because we're going to check which pages someone visited. So I, for example, want to know, okay, what kind of tutorials did someone watch? So if I go to if else, and then I have to make like a condition, I say like, okay, has visited. Now, like an exact page, if you have like a certain article that has like a certain topic, you could do that. But what I want to do is I want to have all the pages that contain ActiveCampaign, because I know that I have a lot of articles on my website, a lot of tutorials. And if it's about ActiveCampaign, I often or almost always include the word ActiveCampaign in the URL. So if someone visits that page, I want them to follow this path. But I do not want to do this when they visit the page once. Maybe they came on the page by accident, so I do not want to trigger it right away. So here you can set how often someone should visit a page that contains that word. So I'm going to set it to 2 to 5 times. And then I'm going to click add. Now, then you see that we have a yes path and a no path. So really easy. Everyone who visited a URL on my website that contains ActiveCampaign at least 2 times will follow and will continue into the yes path. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a tag, and I call it interest between brackets. That's like the category of the tag. I find it really handy for myself. Interest is ActiveCampaign, something like that. And then I'm going to click save. And then we're going to repeat this a few times for like different categories. So I don't know, maybe you have a website about clothing, and then you can tag what kind of clothing someone is interested in, or you can maybe figure out if they're a man or a woman based on if they visit pages that are about skirts or pages that are about, I don't know, swimming trunks, like something like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to check if someone also visited a page, has visited, contains. Now I have a few tutorials about MiniChat, for example, and I'm going to check if they visited that page 2 times. And then if that's the case, I'm going to add a tag that says interest MiniChat. And then what we want to do is we want to check this multiple times for everyone, right? And right now, if someone would visit the ActiveCampaign automation or like page twice, they would go here and then they exit the automation. So what you want to do is you want to add a go to another action. And then this one goes over to the next one. So then after we did that, we also check if they did that. Now let's add one more. Then I'm going to do has visited URL contains automation at least 2 times. I'm going to add that, and then I'm going to add a tag that says interest marketing automation. And then again here we're going to add a go to, and we drag it over here now. And then if that's all that you want to track right now, then you can just end the automation, and then also this one we drag over to this end automation. So then if you want to add more things later on, you can just extend this automation. And yeah, that's basically how you do the interest tagging. So this is based on URLs. You can also do a bunch of different things, but I found this really cool. So yeah, you can do that. Now, then our second example is an abandoned cart, a really simple version for people that are already on your list. So obviously people have to be on your list in order to track them, right? So what we want to do then is we create a new automation. Create automation. Start from scratch. Continue. And by the way, I will also put these automations in the description below, so that you can just simply import them into ActiveCampaign so that you can play around with it. And then I'm going to call this abandonment cart. Let's come up with funnels that convert. So this is like an abandonment cart for one product. So I want to add a start trigger, and I want to add the checkout page of that product. Checkout funnels that convert. And then I'm going to add a wildcard behind it, because sometimes I use add some parameters or other things. I just want to make sure that's triggering every time. And then I'm going to say here, run multiple times. And here I'm going to add automation. So I want to check if someone is not currently in this automation. Let's see if it's already there. It's already there. So currently not, as you say. Not currently in automation, abandonment, cart. All right, add start. So what happens now is that everyone who visits that page for that product and is not currently in this automation will enter this automation. So how this abandonment cart works is we are going to add everyone into this automation who visits that page. Then we are going to wait for 30 minutes. So that time just gives them the time to check out, basically, because if you're going to send an abandonment cart email a minute after they visited that page, then you don't give people the time to even complete the form. And then after those 30 minutes, we're going to check if that person purchased the offer or not. So what we do is we're going to check has visit URL contains success confirmed funnels that convert. Now, if they ever visited that page, then we know that they purchased that product. So obviously this depends a bit on how your checkout software works. I just have different checkout pages, different success pages, so that I can really easily track what is happening. And I'm also going to check if they have a purchase tag. So if someone purchases one of my courses, so for in this instance, it's funnels that convert, then with ThriveCart, I'm automatically adding a tag to ActiveCampaign so that I exactly know who purchased what. But you still want to check both, because some people are ordering with a different email address. So then you want to use the site tracking. And then I'm going to add that. Now, if they visited the confirmed page or if they have the tag, then we want to end the automation. And then if not, we want to send our abandonment cart email. Now, what you put in that email, I leave that up to you. I would suggest a simple subject, like any questions or any questions about funnels that convert or about your order or something like that. I will just leave this, save and exit. And then obviously you also link back to that checkout page again. And then I'm going to click here. We're going to end the automation. And then one more thing that I would suggest doing is to add another delay, because you want to make sure that people are not getting this email over and over again. It would be a bit annoying, right? So we made the trigger in such a way that it's not triggering for everyone who's currently in this automation. So what I suggest doing is add another wait here, and then we add a wait for 2 weeks. So if they visit the checkout page again in those 2 weeks, nothing will happen. If after 2 weeks they visit the page again and again they do not purchase, so they do not follow that path, then we send our any questions email. So this is a really simple way to set up your abandonment cart without any difficult scripts, or just by using simple site tracking of ActiveCampaign. Now, then the third thing I want to show you is how you can exit promotions automatically on purchase. Now, what I mean with that is that when you, for example, have an email course, and if you want to create an email course, I created a cool tutorial about that, just click the cart. But here's the course, and then in the end of the course, we do a 3-day limited time offer. Now, what you can do with sidetracking also is you can check if someone visited that confirmed page, and if they did, you can automatically skip all these follow-ups that people that remind people about a deadline. So this is a 3-day limited time offer, and here they, for example, get a bonus lesson, a cool story, then a reminder about the last day that the offer is valid, your questions answered, and then a last chance email. Now, if someone purchases your offer right away, so in this case it would be in lesson 5 or maybe in the bonus lesson, you do not want to send these follow-ups. Like, that's going to be really annoying for people to be like, hey, but I purchased your offer, why are you still emailing me? So what you can do is you can add a goal to the end of your automation, and then you can just add to the goal has visited that certain page. So here again, we check if they have the tag exists sales purchase funnels that convert. Now, if so, then they will jump there. Or has visited URL. Now, and then you can type here, confirmed funnels that convert. Now, and then I'm also checking that they at least have been sent the last lesson, so that they do not skip to that goal when they join this free course, for example. Because then they would not receive any lessons. But this way, they will at least receive all the lessons and then jump to the goal. So yeah, goals are also a really cool way to use sidetracking. And yeah, that is basically it. That's how you install the tracking script. And yeah, some cool possibilities. And I would really love to hear from you how you are planning on using this. Like, do you maybe have anything cool? Then please, please, please just let me know in the comments below. I'm super interested. And if you have any questions about this, just drop a comment below and then I will get back to you as soon as possible. Okay, thanks for watching. I see you in the next one.